If you've ever played Consequences, you'll know that it ends up with the world said, and the consequence was. Well, if the world says anything at all about me, it says that I'm an actress, born in Australia, ex-Mrs. James Bond, written a couple of books. I suppose the consequence of those things is this film, but this film is not really about any of those things. I'd like to take you with me on a journey and meet some of the people I met on my way. People of all ages and professions and nationalities. People like me, searching for something. I had decided to stop playing Pavlov's dog and waiting for the applause, the repetition of roles, conditioned reflexes. I wanted to learn something. So like all sensible children, I went back to school. Of course, in our game of consequences, the world would have said that it was all grossly coincidental. It just happened that this school started as I stopped. But I'm not a great believer in coincidence, so here I was, one of the first students of the International Academy of Continuous Education. Rather a grand title, perhaps. But anyone of any age can come here, and they can learn practically anything. This is a school you never really leave, because you must take what you learn with you when you go at the end of the year. Because like all real learning, a year is only a beginning. It takes many years to assimilate what you learn here. I often come back. Even more, I think of myself back here. Not only then, but now, and perhaps whenever. Digging and planting and hoeing. Play the tapes backwards, unravel, knit one, purl two, stop, think. There's an expression, killing time. This is where you learn to feel time, not kill time. No one can tell you how to do it. It just has to happen. There's another thing. If you reverse a car, you have to stop it before you can start to go forward again. Otherwise, the engine will fall out. Aldous Huxley wrote a novel called Time Must Have a Stop. Sometimes you find yourself wishing that you could stop time. Well, you can, and you do. That's something you'll hear a lot of here. Stop, when you first come. It's done for a purpose. Like everything else here. And the purpose is that you stop everything. But you stand outside yourself and look. And what you find is your own experience. Some people find fantasies. Some people find no one home at all. But whatever you find, it gives you a greater awareness of yourself. Every stop is a step back to the real person, the unconditioned you, the child. Conditioning starts from birth, and by school time...
Dreadful, well done. You could do better.
There's an old Cambodian monk I met who believes that there are lots of ways, if only we open our eyes.
There is nothing impossible in this world, but of course we have to open our mind and our heart and see all around us whether how far the present-day education has brought us. It is not enough. It is not sufficient. Mm. It is what you call half-done, half-baked man. That's what it has been making.
Half-baked man.
Yes.
Well, how can we begin to learn this other side? I mean, the other half.
I can tell you that people of today, they are quite awake.
Awake?
Yes.
They do know.
Well, they do know, and they are searching for the missing thing in their life. Mm. And that is why so many things sprung up. So many of them, you can imagine. And I was so amazed as why you are so seem to be swallowing thing without much thinking, like
like what?
While children swallow candy.
Is this the candy he meant? Those people have been shouting all day, and busloads are still arriving at Alexandra Palace to shout some more. They too are looking for a way through the woods. Knowledge, if you wish. And they believe that a 15-year-old guru can show them the way.
See, Guruji just, he's the Lord, you know?
He let me hear music of God, the angels of God, taste nectar. It was really blissful, you know?
We were in Munich and we get no knowledge, and now we're in London. We hope that we get knowledge now.
You know, this knowledge gives you a peace,
yes,
which passes all understanding.
Yes.
It's beyond
words,
the comprehension of the mind. It's a thing that can only be experienced once your mind is still.
Mm-hmm.
Once your mind is still, you experience the reality which lies outside your mind.
How do you make your mind still?
By receiving Guru Maharaj's knowledge. It's the only way.
The only way?
The only way.
The only way? I can't believe that it really is. But Alexandra Palace is bursting with people who've come along to be illuminated, to get switched on by the Guru. The rally. Mass devotion or masturbation? Get it now. Get it quick. Is this the way? Do you think you can find anything quickly like that? I mean, instant knowledge, instant religion. Or instant anything. Learning.
You see, I have told so many people that there is no ready-made thing.
In, no, man.
Particularly in Buddhism, no ready-made. You have to dig out.
You have to dig it out?
Yes. If you want cheap thing, of course you can have so many others everywhere. But if you want the real thing, it is not so easy to get.
You've got to dig it out.
Dig it out. Color is everywhere. It pervades the whole world, the whole universe. All life express itself through color. To me, I feel that life, light, and color are not only identical, but they are one and the same. Now, why we are meditating on color? We have selected to meditate on this green color because we feel that this color is the most important among all the seven colors of the solar spectrum. It is a balancing color. It stands in the mid between those who belong to the hot side and those who belong to the cold side. And that is one thing. Another thing, where there is greenness, there is life, there is energy, there is freshness, and there is safety. Now let's meditate
This is where I discovered some doors to open for myself. This is where my journey and a lot of other people's journeys converged. I came here because I needed to. It's a bit like stepping off a cliff to leave all the comforts and securities behind, to come to a place solely to learn. Oh, of course, we had to pay for our stopover. Not much, but we had to earn the money ourselves before we arrived. In the game of consequences, the world would say we were mad. A bit odd. But we didn't have time to worry about what the world would say. And the consequence was, well, at the end of our year, we've all gone back to our lives. But with our eyes just a bit more open. One thing I do know for sure is that next year, 90 more travelers will be looking for direction from the man whose brainchild this place is. John Godolphin Bennett, writer, mathematician, and philosopher.
Stop! Living in a body. This body is an essential part of the whole of our human experience. It is not something separate. The body is the link between the inner and the outer world, and we don't know how to use this body. And for that, these training movements, the learning to use the body as a means of expression, learning the language of gesture, learning to control one's body in delicate and difficult and sometimes very awkward ways. This is a great revelation. I mean, one suddenly realizes this wonderful instrument, I've never seen what it can do for me. Now we're going to work now on the Lord have mercy, but on the inner work. As you know, with all of Gurdjieff movements, and this is number 11 of the 39 series, there is always something that we have to do inside ourselves with our inner state, with our attention. And in this particular one, there are three things. We have to work on the sensation and on feeling. And also we have to have a mental image of what Lord have mercy signifies. This threefold thing of thought, feeling, and organic sensation all must be there when you're making this these gestures. And Lord have mercy.
Put the top pin up there, and then we'll slide the bottom in. Beam's in the way.
There you go.
Your way.
station in the morning.
Seeing these children doing their version of the kind of thing I did at Sherborne led me to ask John Bennett how he saw their future, the future of a new generation.
There's a real desire for life. It's quite extraordinary. I remember myself as a boy. Of course, we all have had a desire for life, but they want to live much more. They already know that there's something that's missing in life, and they want it. And then they get this offered to them at school as a kind of ersatz, an imitation of it. You know, you talked about freedom, and people at various schools, they're trying to give the children freedom. But you don't give freedom. I mean, you try to pump it into them. You don't give it to them. They've got to get the freedom from inside themselves, and they don't know how to do that. You know very well that that's the thing that we're after here.
I'll be server.
Me too.
Oh, I will too.
Oh, no, you can serve.
Okay.
No, you can let me. Like,
you know very well what our principle is, that man is only half-developed being. That whatever education he has, he remains only half-developed. This potential in him has got to come out. And the way we live at the present time just doesn't make this possible. The first thing for getting this potential out is to know it. One must know that one's got it. Not from somebody else, one must know it from oneself. One must know that there are springs inside oneself that are not yet flowing. I mean, one must have the positive with the negative. One must take away illusions, but one must also give hope. This possibly is what the world most needs this present time, to have a genuine hope for the future.
No.
Oh, let's see where we got to go today. Look there. Oh, it's weeding the rose garden. We did this yesterday.
And the day before.
And the day before that as well.
And the day before that.
This, to know that today one will teach, tomorrow one will learn, this is the thing that gives us confidence that we can play any role that's given to us. Yes, including that, the role which is our own destiny, which we've got to find. After all, it's not just in order to be versatile. It's
yes.
Far beyond that. It is only the discovery of versatility is the step towards discovering our super potential.
What do you mean by super potential?
I mean that our ordinary faculties, our speech and thinking and so on, are not the whole of our potential. We have the possibility of other perceptions, as you know. And this is one of the remarkable things, that in this relatively short time, people began to be aware that they could be in contact with one another, they could understand one another without words. Mm. This is the beginning of the emerging of the super potential. And I think it's particularly important at this time, because with the world as it is, we're going to need other means of communication. Not through words,
yes.
Not from the outside. We're so jammed together that we've got to be able to understand one another and accept one another quite differently. All that belongs to the super potential. There's going to be need for new ways of understanding one another, new ways of accepting one another. We're moving into a new kind of society. We can dimly see what it's going to be, and we know that we're not prepared for it. That is the crux of the whole of this educational crisis in which we are.
Stop!
So here I am, still traveling. What do I get out of the journey? We could talk about joy, or happiness, or fulfillment. But those are words, and words are no longer enough. It's what we put into the journey that counts.
Da 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 together. Dum 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 dum. Stop! Oh, dash, on down. What a pity. Never mind. Get him down next time. All together. Dum dum dum.